So this class is going to focus on inferential statistics, which in all cases we're going to be observing a sample and making inferences about populations. And all of the tests that we're going to look at assume random sampling. And random sampling is when you have a population and the individuals in the population are chosen to be in your sample such that every individual in the population has the same chance as everybody else of being in your sample. So random sampling is everyone in the population has the same chance or probability of being in your sample. So if this is what the population looks like, right, I'm just making it so each little dot's a person, and we do some random sampling to get our sample. So this is the population. This is a sample. If we end up, so these are the individuals that are in our sample. They're a subset of the population. So if it's a random sample, every one of these people has an equal probability as everybody else of ending up in our sample. So they would just be completely randomly picked from the group to be brought into our sample. So all of the inferential statistics that we talk about in this class assume that the population is here. We use random sampling to get our sample. And then what that allows us to do is once we have our sample, we measure our sample, and if it was a random sample, then we can be pretty confident in our inferences from our sample back to our population. In research, there's a concept that's kind of like random sampling, but a little bit different. And it's important that you know the distinction, right? So random sampling is if everybody in the population has an equal chance of being in your sample. There's this other concept called random assignment, and this is relevant for experiments. Each person in your sample has the same probability as everybody else in your sample of being in your experimental conditions, right? So this is just for experiments. Here, you start off with a sample. You've already done your sampling from the population and you have a sample of individuals already before random assignment happens. So theoretically, you do random sampling to get your sample. Then once you have your sample, then you could do this random assignment. So you could have your participants show up to your lab, and you flip a coin, and if it's heads, they're in your caffeine condition. If it's tails, then they're drinking decaffeinated coffee. All right, and so each of these individuals has an equal chance as every other individual of being in your two experimental conditions, right? And this middle process here, this would be the random assignment. And you could literally flip a coin and that would produce a random assignment of individuals to your two different conditions. And this is done in experiments, and this is assumed for all different research. This class is going to assume this for all of the inferential statistics that we do. Random assignment isn't at all a central feature of this class. It's a really big deal in research methods class because experiments, all true experiments have random assignment, and that balances out all the characteristics of people in the caffeine group with those in the decaf group. So the only difference between these two groups is what you've done to them. And the reason that's so critical is that these experiments are the only way that scientists can get strong evidence for a causal claim. All the other kind of research that we do, we can't make strong causal claims. We can just say that two variables are associated with each other. But again, this experimental method is something more for a research methods class, and we won't focus on random assignment in this class, but random sampling is going to be a big deal.